Let's read the question, students. SO bond order in SO4 2 minus ion is. Student, for this question, first of all, we have to draw the structure of SO4 2 minus, that is sulfate ion, which is S double bond O, O minus O minus. Now we can calculate bond order, which is equals to number of sigma bonds plus number of pi bonds upon number of sigma bonds. Student, here sigma bonds are 4 and pi bonds are 2. So 4 plus 2 upon 4, which is equals to 1.5. That means the correct answer is option number 2. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 57. Let's read the question. Paramagnetic species among the following is R. Students, in this question, we are given with three species, that is B2, C2 and O2. And we have to identify that which among the species, which among the following is paramagnetic in nature. And for that, we need to know that the species which has unpaired electrons are paramagnetic. On the other hand, the species which has no unpaired electrons or which has all the electrons paired are diamagnetic species. We need to write the molecular orbital configuration of the given species. So let's start with B2. I'm writing the molecular orbital configuration. For that, we need to write the atomic number. For that, we need to calculate the total number of electrons present in B2. Since the atomic number of boron is 5, therefore total 10 electrons are present. So let's write the electronic configuration. Sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2. Then we have pi 2px1 and then pi 2py1. So it is very clear that B2 has unpaired electrons. That means B2 is paramagnetic. Now let's write the electronic configuration of C2. The electrons are 12. So sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2. Then we have pi 2px2 and then pi 2py2. That means there is no unpaired electrons. As a result, C2 is diamagnetic. Let's proceed with O2. Total number of electrons are 16. Configuration is sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2. In this case, that is in case of O2, we have sigma 2pz before pi 2px and pi 2py. So this is 2. Then we have pi 2px1 and pi 2py1. So it is very clear that O2 is also paramagnetic. That means the correct answer is option number 4. Both 1 and 3, that is both B2 and O2, are paramagnetic species. So the correct answer is option number 4. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 58. The compound which is least soluble in water is. Students, the compound which are either polar or which form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water are soluble in water. Among the given options, acetone, ethanol and ethanol are soluble in water, and hexane, which is a non-polar compound, is insoluble, or we can say that is least soluble in water. So the correct answer for this question is option number 3. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 59. Let's read the question. Two cylinders of equal volume contain H2 and CH4 separately at 5 atm, that is 5 atmospheric pressure and 27 degrees Celsius temperature. The ratio of the density of H2 to CH4 present in the respective cylinder is. Student, for this question, first of all, we need to know that density is equals to PM upon RT. Also, we need to know that in both the cases, that in the case of H2 and CH4, the pressure and temperature is constant. Therefore, density of H2 upon density of CH4 is equals to molar mass of H2 upon molar mass of CH4. Since the molar mass of H2 is 2 and the molar mass of CH4 is 16, which is equals to 1 upon 8. That means the correct ratio is 1:8. So the correct answer is option number 3. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 60. Let's see the question, students. the gas which is most easily liquefied is? Students, in this question we are given with four gases, that is CO2, NH3, O2 and N2, and we have to identify that which gas is most easily liquefied. For that we need to know that higher the polarity of a gas, easier is it to liquefy. Also, NH3 among the given molecules is most polar, hence its critical temperature will be high. As a result, it will be most easily liquefied. So the correct answer for this question is option number 2, that is NH3. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 61.